Hi everyone, this is Advocate Nikita Kohli, Senior Legal Associate from NRI Legal Services. Today I will be sharing with you some information relating to the claims against the developers, keeping in mind the dilemma of the NRIs. The purpose for making this video is to apprise the NRIs who are lured into investing their hard-earned money for buying properties in India. Therefore, kindly watch this video till the end so that you do not miss out on any information. I hope this shall be helpful for many of you. Well, NRIs, in order to stay connected to their origins, make investments in the real estate in India, be it residential or commercial. And subsequently, they end up making significant investments for buying properties in India. The developers of such projects make NRIs as their prime focus due to their economic strength, and coax them into buying properties in India by showing them glorified models of the projects and beautiful brochures. They deceive the NRIs by making false promises and giving them vague assurances, which ultimately at a later stage results into a dispute between a buyer and a developer. In this video, I will be covering the following aspects relating to the claims against the developers. First, what gives rise to a dispute between a buyer and a developer? Second, what all documents are required to be possessed by a buyer? And third, in case there is a dispute between a buyer and a developer, which authority or forum can be resorted to in that scenario? Now, I will be sharing with you some issues which may result into a dispute between a buyer and a developer one by one. The first one is the delay in handing over of the possession to the buyer by the developer within stipulated timelines. What is a stipulated timeline? It is a timeline within which the developer is supposed to hand over the physical possession of the property to the buyer, which is generally mentioned in the agreement which is executed between a buyer and a developer. The second one is the inability of the developer to complete the project in time. The third is the deficiency in the quality of the construction of the project, which is many a times is not at all comparable to what it was shown to the buyers at the very initial stages when he or she was entrusted in buying the property. Fourth is non-compliance to the clauses mentioned in the agreement, which is executed between a buyer and a developer. Fifth is no communication at all between a buyer and a developer upon the construction or the progress of the project. Now, this particular issue is of a major concern when it comes to NRIs, because NRIs are situated far away from their properties and it becomes very difficult for them to have a constant communication with the developers who are based in India. The sixth issue is the amendment in the layout plan of the building or the structure without the prior approval of the buyer. The seventh issue is the demand of additional fees or hidden fees by the developers from the buyers in order to harass them. The above mentioned issues which I have just discussed are the reasons why there has been a plethora of cases going on between the buyers and the developers all over India. And the problem becomes more crucial when the buyer is at NRI, as they are not fully aware of their legal rights and constantly changing legal scenario with respect to the consumer protection in India. Subsequently, what happens is they have to give up on their dream of owning a property in India, which is shattered by the unscrupulous developers, which leads to the mental agony and harassment to the NRIs. Coming to the aspect of the requisite documents which are required to be possessed by the buyers. The first one is the allotment letter issued by the developer. An allotment letter should contain all the details of the buyer, the developer, and the complete description of the property, such as the area of the property, the price of the property, along with the proper bifurcation. The second important document is the buyer's agreement. It is executed between a buyer and a developer and contain all the terms and conditions governing both the parties, the buyer and the developer. Then there is apartment buyer's agreement in case there is a sale of an apartment or a flat फ्लोर बायर्स अग्रीमेंट इन केस देर इज अ सेल ऑफ अ फ्लोर. नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट डॉक्यूमेंट विच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इज द ट्राइपार्टाइट अग्रीमेंट. इट इज एग्जीक्यूटेड बाय द डिवेलपर बायर एंड द फाइनेंसिंग इंस्टीट्यूशन. इट इज एग्जीक्यूटेड इन केसेस अ बायर इज गोइंग फॉर अ लोन टू फाइनेंस हिज और हर प्रॉपर्टी. देन नेक्स्ट डॉक्यूमेंट इज द रिसीट्स इशूड बाय द डिवेलपर इन फेवर ऑफ द बायर. अ रिसीट शुड बी कंप्लीटली लेजिबल. इट शुड कंटेन द सिग्नेचर्स ऑफ द ऑथराइज्ड सिग्नेटरी एंड द कंप्लीट डिटेल्स ऑफ द बायर एंड द डिवेलपर. देन द नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट डॉक्यूमेंट इज द correspondences, which is written correspondences between the buyer and the developer, such as WhatsApp, emails and so on. Then there are other miscellaneous documents such as bank statements, the account statements issued by the developer, site plans, brochures, maps of the property and so on. Well, there may arise situations when there is a dispute between a buyer and a developer. Then in that scenario, the following two remedies can be resorted to. First is to approach a consumer forum. Second is to approach RERA. The procedure which are followed by the consumer forum is governed by the Consumer Protection Act. Initially, there was the Consumer Protection Act of 1986, which was there to protect the interests of the consumers, which last year has been replaced by the Consumer Protection Act of 2019. The Act of 2019 was enacted keeping in mind the lacunas which were present in the Act of 1986 and to keep up with the modern digitized and electronic era. Then in the year 2016 came RERA, that is Real Estate Regulation and Development Act, which was enacted to bring the transparency among the real estate transactions and to ensure the interests of the consumers are protected, and further the malpractices by the developers are minimized or completely eliminated. Well, moving on to the concept of limitation. What is a limitation period? It is a time period within which an aggrieved person is supposed to approach an appropriate forum or the authority. Under the Consumer Protection Act, there is a limitation period of 2 years from the date of the cause of action within which an aggrieved person has to approach an appropriate forum. Whereas the RERA is concerned, there is no such prescribed time period, but it should be reasonable. Further, I would like to now discuss with you the concept of jurisdiction. The jurisdiction means the competency of the court to entertain any complaint. Under the claims against the developers, there are specifically two types of jurisdiction which needs to be considered. First is the territorial jurisdiction. Second is the pecuniary jurisdiction. Territorial jurisdiction is the jurisdiction which is based upon the area, that is territory. Now, whenever an aggrieved person has to file a consumer complaint in a consumer forum, three options are available to that aggrieved person. First, where the complainant resides or personally works for gain. Second, where the opposite party reside or conducted its business. Third, where the cause of action arose. Now, moving on to the RERA, whenever a complaint is to be filed under the regulatory authority of the state, it is filed where the property is situated. Then there is pecuniary jurisdiction, which is based upon the amount of claim which an aggrieved person is making against the developer. Whenever the amount a person is claiming is up to 1 crore, the complaint will lie to the district commission. When the amount of claim is beyond 1 crore up to 10 crore, the consumer complaint will lie to the state commission, and beyond 10 crore, the consumer complaint will lie to the national commission. Whereas the RERA is concerned, there is no such concept of pecuniary limits. Now, moving on to the concept of appeal, I would say whenever a person is aggrieved by the order of the district commission, an appeal shall lie to the state commission. And aggrieved from the order of the state commission, he will approach the national commission. And aggrieved from the order of the national commission can approach the Supreme Court of India. Now, under the RERA, what happens is when a complaint is adjudicated before the regulatory authority of the state,
An appeal will lie to the appellate authority. After appellate authority, the appeal will lie to the High Court of the state, then subsequently to the Supreme Court of India.
So that brings us to the end, and here I would like to say that we at NRI Legal Services offer for the resolution of any kind of legal issue pertaining to the claims against the developers. We always ensure that our clients receive the full refund of the amounts invested by them along with the interest, damages and compensation. Sometimes what happens is the opposite party, that is the developers, they approach us for the settlement while the litigation is going on. In that scenario, we always ensure that a fair settlement is arrived at, keeping in mind the interest of the clients. So friends, I hope I have been able to clarify all your doubts. And in case you still have any query, please leave your queries at our official email ID, that is query@nrilegalservices.com, or you can also leave a comment in the comment section below. We will be happy to assist you. Now, in order to stay connected or get the latest notification, please follow our pages on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. On behalf of the NRI family, I would like to wish all of you Merry Christmas and a very Happy New Year. Thank you so much.